So you actually train these engineers. So you know what they're going through. You know what they deal with on a daily basis. Take us through right now what it would feel like going around a bend at about 50 miles per hour.
Okay.
So you can, I mean, you can tell what it feels like. It's pretty controlled, right? How would you describe it?
Well, it's kind of like going from a sports car to a really big truck, okay? In a sports car, you have a sense of how fast you're going. Once you get into a big truck, you may be going 80 miles an hour, but it feels like you're only going like 40.
So this is 50 miles an hour, again, going around or approaching the bend at least, still very controlled. So on this one, let's see, I want to go around a bend again and see what it feels like at like 75 miles per hour. I just want to see the difference. So this bend right now, we're going in, we're already up to 66, I can see. So it's going to feel, it already feels faster.
Yeah.
I can already sense it. Even though we're not moving, I can sense how fast we're going already. I want to know what it would feel like. We know that this engineer apparently threw the emergency brake full force all the way down. What would it feel like? What would we get a sense of if we did that right here at about 70 miles per hour?
Well, I'll show you.
So that's full force on the brakes at just 60 miles per hour, and we're still going.
Yeah. Yeah, that's you can't apply the brakes any harder than that.
And it still doesn't stop automatically. It takes some time, no matter what speed you're going.
Yes, a fully loaded freight train, an average freight train, which is roughly 80, 85 cars, takes over a mile to stop in an emergency.
All right, so now let's take it around the bend as fast as you can go. I mean, they're saying this train that derailed might have been going about 106 miles per hour, so let's see what this one does.
Well, we'll see how close we can get.
Okay. So we're going so fast, we're going to derail right here.
Yes. Right on that curve right there.
Okay. Okay, so explain that. So why would it derail?
Why it derails is because there's so much force at when you're going around that curve that locomotive becomes top heavy and it just rolls over. It's too much centrifugal force for it to stay on.
Yeah, and all the people inside, they describe, you know, laptops falling and people falling on top of them, and even one woman described a couple of people above her had gotten stuck in the luggage rack. Does any of that surprise you, going around a bend at that speed?
Not at all. Not at all. I mean, we were only going 72 and a half.
Mm-hmm.
So, you add 30 more miles an hour to that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's a lot of force there. People will be thrown around.
And Randi joins us now from outside that simulator. The instructor told you that it takes about a mile to stop after an engineer applies the brakes. So does he think the engineer of this train crash, I mean, I guess he would think he didn't even have a chance to really make any impact, any lessening of the speed before the impact.
Absolutely, Anders, and he doesn't think he had a chance. He said you need about 30 seconds or at least a mile after applying the brakes for that train to slow down. And he said if what the NTSB says is true, and the engineer in this case applied those brakes just moments before entering that curve, our instructor said there's no way he would have had time. He certainly wouldn't have had that 30 seconds or that mile to get to that safe speed. And another thing, Anderson, that surprised him, he said he would be really surprised if the engineer in this case didn't see that upcoming curve. He said because on a clear night, you can see those railroad signals, which he says are so bright, you can see them for up to 10 miles. He told me that he's seen that with his own eyes. And especially if you're going down a straight track, you can see where that bend would start. You can see how the lights begin to curve. So if he didn't see that, he's wondering why. Was it weather? Was it heavy fog? Was it bad rain? Was it something else? Still so many questions, Anderson, even for the experts tonight.
Yeah, and of course, that's why they want to hear from that engineer. Randi, I appreciate that.